Hi, welcome back to Genius Lounge. I'm your host, Matt Troutman. So I bet you didn't realize that there are two different kinds of photo albums that exist on your phone. One is designed to stay on your phone, and then one is designed specifically for sharing with other people. So I'm gonna go ahead and open up the Photos app on my phone and we'll get started. So here I have a selection of photos that were taken for a family portrait session. So what I wanna do is I wanna select a few of these and just help organize them on my phone a little bit better. So I'm gonna go ahead and tap select here in the upper right-hand corner. And then I'm gonna select all the photos that I would like to add to this particular album. The first example album that I'm going to create here is one that exists just on my phone or my other iCloud devices. All right, there we go. I've selected 50 photos. In the lower center of my screen, I'm gonna go ahead and tap Add To. And I don't have any existing albums in my iCloud account, so I'm just going to go ahead and tap New Album right there, that gray square. And I'm going to give it the name of Photos 2017. I'm gonna save that. You saw that little animation of the photos flying into that album. Now what I can do is if I tap in the lower right of my screen, I can see albums, scroll all the way to the bottom, and here are my created albums. And I can see that all 50 of those photos are there. Now what if I went to a family picnic or a work offsite and I took some really awesome pictures, and so did some other people, and we want to all share those together? Well, there's a solution for that too. I'm going to go ahead and scroll up here. I've got a different set of photos that I'd like to share with a group of people. I'm going to tap select, select all the photos that I'd like, and instead of tapping add to, in this situation, I'm going to go ahead and tap the share button in the lower left of my screen. From here, what I can do is I can tap iCloud photo sharing. And what this will prompt me to do is to create a new shared album, the name of which I'm going to say is Random Family Pictures. And it's asking me who I would like to invite to this particular album. At this point, I'm not going to invite anyone, but I'm just going to tell it create, and I can tell it post. Now, if I wanted to see where those pictures actually went, third from the left in the lower portion of my screen, I see shared. And it tells me I've had a little bit of activity on my shared feed, but also if I tap the arrow in the upper left-hand corner, that will take me to all the different shared albums that I'm a part of. Now, not only are these up in the cloud and these are shareable to other people, if I want to add someone to the group, all I have to do is tap the People tab at the lower part of the screen there. And I can say, I want to invite people, and it gives me some suggestions here of other people who are able to be invited. The other really cool part here is, even if someone doesn't have an iPhone, they can still be part of the group and still see the pictures that you've taken. You can check public website right there, and it will take those photos public for you so that anyone with the link will be able to view those. So the really cool part here is that anybody who's a part of that group has the option to contribute to the photo album. And that makes a really awesome experience if you maybe weren't able to stay for the whole party, or you missed the candles being blown out on a birthday cake. So those are the two different photo album types that are available on your iPhone. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to give us a thumbs up down below. And if you want to get notifications when we post new content, go ahead and hit that little subscribe button down below and click the little bell. That way we can let you know about new videos every time we post. Thank you so much for joining us. I'm Matt Troutman, and I'll see you next time in the Genius Lounge.